Good evening.
Good evening.
We would like to welcome all to the Cathedral Church of the Sacred Heart. Today, we celebrate the 50th anniversary of the dedication of the cathedral, as well as the 50th anniversary of the priesthood of Bishop Emeritus Michael D. Pfeiffer. The mother church of all the churches in a diocese is the cathedral. It houses the bishop's cathedra, the bishop's seat, from which it receives its name. The cathedral is the sign of diocesan unity. It is the place where that unity can be given concrete expression. During this holy sacrifice of the Mass, we offer praise to our God for his blessings on our diocese, our cathedral, and our Bishop Emeritus. We invite you to participate fully in this celebration by using the provided worship aid. Immediately following the Mass, a reception with Bishop Pfeiffer will be held in the Parish Ministry Center Gym, which is located in the building next to the cathedral, and all are certainly welcome. I now invite you to please stand to greet His Excellency, the Bishop Emeritus of the Diocese of St. Angelo, Bishop Michael David Pfeiffer.
Thank you.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace, the love, and joy of Jesus Christ, our Savior and great High Priest, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome. 250s. 250s. Thank you for being here to celebrate the consecration of our beautiful Sacred Heart Cathedral, and coming to join me as I have the privilege of completing 50 years of priesthood. I welcome all of you, especially my brother bishops, of course our own bishop, Bishop Michael Sis. Thank you for inviting the bishop. Happy to God celebrate with you. Bishop Placido Rodriguez from beautiful Lubbock. Bishop Joseph Strickland from out in Tyler. Bishop James Tamayo from Laredo. Bishop Mark Sides from El Paso. And Bishop Doug Jessotel from Dallas. Welcome. Welcome to my priest brother, Ted Pfeiffer, Father Ted Pfeiffer, my sister Judy, and some cousins that are here. To prepare ourselves to celebrate with Christ these sacred mysteries, we pause for a moment to reflect on our lives, realize that we fail, but that God is merciful, and we open our hearts to receive God's forgiveness and God's pardon.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie.
God, who year by year renew for us today, when this your holy temple was consecrated, hear the prayers of your people and grant that in this place, for you there may always be pure worship and for us fullness of redemption through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just. For my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering to him, loving the name of the Lord, and becoming his servants, all who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, them I will bring to my holy mountain, and they joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar. For my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Efesios. Hermanos, ya no son ustedes extranjeros ni alienígenas, son conciudadanos de los santos y pertenecen a la familia de Dios, porque han sido edificados sobre el cimiento de los apóstoles y de los profetas, siendo Cristo Jesús la piedra angular. Sobre Cristo, todo el edificio se va levantando bien estructurado para formar el templo santo en el Señor. Y unidos a Él también, ustedes se van incorporando al edificio por medio del Espíritu Santo para ser morada de Dios. Palabra de Dios.
Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cord and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen. He spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And to those who sold doves, he said, "Take these out of here and stop making my father's house a marketplace." His disciples recalled the words of Scripture, "Zeal for your house will consume me." At this, the Jews answered and said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days." But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the Scripture and the word that Jesus had spoken. The Gospel of the Lord.